For Senator Ronald De La Rosa, it's time for government to end the peace talks and to finish off the communist rebels. During a Senate hearing this past Tuesday, the former police chief said the CPP-NPA has not been sincere in seeking peace. De La Rosa instead accused the communist group of regrouping and rearming its members. He added the country will only flourish once government ends the insurgency problem. Is the Philippine government's anti-insurgency campaign? Well, that hit a snag. That's after a Manila court junked government's attempt to have the Communist Party of the Philippines and the New People's Army declared as terrorists. Mike Navali now joins us with details. Mike?
Hi, Carmina. A Manila court has junked the Philippine government's petition to declare the Communist Party of the Philippines and the New People's Army as terrorist organizations, making clear that rebellion and political acts are not acts of terrorism. In a 135-page resolution, Manila Regional Trial Court Branch 19 Judge Marlo Magdoza Malagar said the CPP-NPA was not organized for the purpose of engaging in terrorism. Armed struggle, he said, is only a means to achieve the CPP's purpose and is not the purpose of the creation of the CPP. After examining the constitution and key documents of the CPP-NPA, the Philippine government filed a prescription case against the two rebel groups in 2018 under the provisions of the Human Security Act of 2007. Which was eventually repealed by the Anti-Terrorism Act of 2020. A prescription case seeks a court ruling declaring as terrorists an organization, association, or group of persons organized to engage in terrorism, or which actually uses the acts to terrorize or to sow and create a condition of widespread and extraordinary fear and panic among the populace to coerce the government to give in to an unlawful demand. The case is filed by the Department of Justice with the Regional Trial Court under the Human Security Act and with the Court of Appeals under the Anti-Terrorism Act. In seeking to declare the CPP-NPA as terrorist groups, the DOJ cited 9 incidents of killings, attempted killings, and abduction from 2019 to 2020 in different areas in Mindanao. The Manila court said that while the 9 incidents it examined can be considered terrorism under the Human Security Act, their authorship could not be traced to the CPP-NPA. Eyewitnesses have only identified the perpetrators through their manner of clothing, wearing an all-black ensemble, which the court said is not enough to determine membership in the rebel groups. According to the court, no evidence was presented by those claiming to be former members of the NPA that there is an official party directive to commit the atrocities or that these were official acts of the CPP-NPA. It pointed out that none of the 9 incidents the Philippine government cited caused widespread and extraordinary fear and panic among the Philippine populace, but only pocket and sporadic occurrences in limited and scattered areas in the country, which could be considered guerrilla warfare, which is not synonymous with terrorism. The court said the government has also not shown that the 9 incidents were meant to coerce the government to give in to a demand as required under the Human Security Act. The court rejected other evidence presented by the government. The purging incidents, it said, were carried out in secrecy, which precluded the likelihood of widespread and extraordinary fear and panic among the populace. The court made clear incidents such as collection of revolutionary taxes, the 1971 Plaza Miranda bombing, which took place before the Human Security Act was passed into law, could not be used against the CPP-NPA in the prescription case. Judge Magdoza Malagar said the acts attributed to CPP-NPA can be considered political crimes, which are treated with leniency compared to the regular crimes under the revised penal code. He went on, in fact, to warn the government against red tagging and also said that to address rebellion, the government must look at addressing the social ills. He said the CPP can only gain adherence for as long as the government remains insensitive to and incompetent in addressing the social realities of poverty and material inequality, which bring with them the oppression of the marginalized. Reacting to the ruling, Bayan Secretary General Renato Reyes Jr. said, terrorist labeling will not end armed conflict. The key takeaway, he said, in the ruling is to junk terrorist labeling versus the CPP-NPA, and in that the government should abandon the policy of terrorist labeling and instead apply the framework of international humanitarian law to the armed conflict in the Philippines. Carmina?
All right, 2 things, Mike. First off, The decision was very clear. Means is not synonymous with purpose. That was part of the decision of the Manila court. Now, question is, can government now still revive their bid to have the CPP-NPA tagged as a terrorist organization even after this ruling?
Carmina, yes, they can still refile this, assuming they have new allegations, they have new basis, new incidents, because the definition of terrorism under the Anti-Terrorism Act is different. In fact, that's the point made by some of the petitioners before the Supreme Court. It's wider now. The definition of terrorism is wider under the Anti-Terrorism Act, which could encompass acts which does not sow terror or panic in the population. So that's one of the things that we're going to look into, whether the government will refile this and what would be the basis, Carmina.
And the next question there, Mike, is will this be enough of a basis now for, because we're talking about a different administration now. This was filed during the last administration. Can this administration now sort of use this as a basis for the resumption of the peace talks?
Well, it depends really on the priority of the administration, Carmina. But yes, the ruling did say that in order to address the root of rebellion, you have to look at the social ills instead of trying to ban them or prescribe them. It remains to be seen if the government will listen to that, Carmina, and we are still asking for the reaction from the Department of Justice, if they will seek a reconsideration of this case, or they will rather file a new case under the Anti-Terrorism Act, where they could have better chances of getting a prescription, Carmina.
Mike Navalio there, thanks. And back here in the newsroom, for former Senator Panfilo Lacson, the court's move should not be interpreted as a setback for the anti-terror law. He says, as author and sponsor of the measure, he made that proscription will be the exclusive authority of the judiciary, since it could involve possible detention of individuals and groups suspected of violating the law.